Hi, I'm Janvi. Today I'm going to propose an IoT idea 2020. The topic is development of EOG based human machine interface control system for virtual keyboard. This system is made for the paralyzed people who are fully or halfly paralyzed but eyes should be working. This system makes the communication between the paralyzed person and others easier. The system communicates based upon the eye movement. Here we are going to measure voltage difference between cornea and retina. Cornea is a transparent front part of the eye. Retina is light sensitive layer at the back of the eye. Then extract the value of EOG, that is the voltage difference due to the movement of the eye. Accordingly, the texts are outputted. An interface or machine which makes the communication of a paralyzed person with others easier. The setup of EOG. It will have three electrodes, red positive, which is kept on the left end of the left eye, black negative, which is kept on the right end of the right eye, and neutral green, which can be put below ears or on the neck or else on the forehead. The electrodes measures the EOG, EEG and EMG biosignals. EOG is electrooculography, EEG is electroencephalography, EMG is electromyography. Measuring voltage difference gives the combined value of EOG, EEG and EMG, which is in between 0.4 to 1 millivolt. As this value is very small, we need to amplify it for the further purposes. We use ADC 620 or 741 to amplify it, which is having an amplification factor of 1000. So it amplifies 1000 times. The output will be 4 to 10 volts. Remember, we are having the value for the mixture of EOG, EEG and EMG, but we need only EOG value, which is the value of eye movement. In order to remove the high noises, EEG and EMG, we use Butterworth LP filter, low pass filter, with cutoff frequency of 30 Hz. The output will be the only EOG which we wanted. Then this is measured by the voltage sensor. According to the value, we select one out of many predefined texts to be executed by the help of Arduino virtual keyboard coding. Example, assume we have coded that I need water or an alphabet A will range between 4 to 3 volts. If we get the input voltage to Arduino in between 4 to 4.3 volts range, then I need water or the alphabet A will be outputted. The output can be displayed on the computer or may trigger an alarm or may be an audio through speaker or can be a message sent on the phone. This is the block diagram. Electrodes, then amplifier, bandpass filter, amplifier, notch filter, comparator and processor. This is the LabVIEW circuit. If you don't have all the components, you can use LabVIEW circuit using LabVIEW. This is the flow chart. Measure the voltage difference between cornea and retina, which will be 0.4 to 1 millivolt. Then ADC 620, amplification by factor of 1000, 4 to 10 volt will be outputted. Butterworth low pass filter with 30 Hz cutoff to remove EEG, EMG and to have only EOG. The EOG output is given to the voltage sensor. Arduino or MATLAB port to work like a virtual keyboard according to the voltage range. Output is on the screen or as audio speaker. So this is the flowchart of the whole system. Then the advantages: an interface or machine which makes the communication of a paralyzed person with others easier. It is concentrating on paralyzed person. Paralyzed people are people whose half body or the full body functionality is disabled. This is the low cost system. It will take very low cost. These are the disadvantages of the system. The problem with this technique is that the disabled person needs someone's help to keep the electrodes. The person can't himself keep the electrodes on his left eye or right eye, end of the right eye, or on his neck. So there should be someone to help him to keep. And the eye movement input is instantly faster than other current input. So when one input is about to process, the eye will move and create another input. So it will be too faster. This is known as saccade movement. So it's difficult to take the input. The potential difference is first of all low, it will be in terms of millivolts, and then the change in the eye movement, like left to right or the right to left, will be in the terms of microvolts. It is very difficult to differentiate it. No electrical component or any component may work in microvolts range, so it's very difficult for this system. So this process takes time. This, in the terms of microvolts, is given to an amplifier so that it will amplify, so that any components will work. The voltage difference which we get is in terms of milli or microvolt, so we need to amplify it, and it takes time. So we can say that this system doesn't work so efficiently in the real time. That is, it takes a lot of time to the process. The main objective of this project is to help physically challenged people who can't use the computer or laptop. This proposed system is aimed towards development of a usable and low-cost brain-computer interface for disabled people. It can be used as a means of control, allowing the handicapped, especially those with only eye motor coordination, to live more independent lives. Eye movements require minimum effort and allow direct selection techniques, and this increases the response time and the rate of information flow. Future enhancement. This is just a prototype. We can develop it more to make it more successful and efficient. Further study is required to remove the problems encountered in measurement of EOG. For example, to make the EOG comfortable, surgically implanted electrodes could be used which provide equivalent signals without cosmetic penalty. The future prospects of current project are vast. In this project, only 3 control signals were generated and transmitted. This can be extended to 5 or 7 with a little modification in the algorithm. Range of operations can also be increased from 100 meter to a much wider range if RF module is replaced by GSM module. By using PDA in place of computer, the system can be converted to a wearable device. Accuracy of the circuit can be improved by using electronic components with high precision and less tolerance. The EOG-based HMI technique discussed in the thesis can be developed as a practical solution by performing these changes. So, this is all how the system works. Paralyzed people will make different eye movements which are sensed by electrodes and are communicated as words to others. Hope this video was helpful. Thank you.